Several environmental groups expressed their opposition to the ongoing reclamation in Manila Bay. Jervis Manahan now joins us on the line for details. Jervis?
Yes, around several organizations led by international advocacy group Oceana Philippines banded together in Chile to express opposition on the ongoing reclamation in Manila Bay. The group sounded alarm on the geohazards that come with the reclamation. Attorney Rose Liza Esma Osorio of Oceana Philippines says reclamation comes at a very high price, especially for food security of the country. She said the Manila Bay has been proven to be a good spawning ground of Sardinella pacifica, a species of fish that is endemic to the Philippines. Meanwhile, Dr. Kelvin Rodolfo, a professor of geology in Chicago, said that there are many risks in reclaiming land, such as land subsidence and liquefaction, that may pose risks to properties built in the reclaimed area. Land subsidence is the sinking of land due to excessive extraction of groundwater. This leads to worse flooding, and its effects are starting to be felt in some areas in Metro Manila and Cavite. On the other hand, liquefaction happens to reclaimed land where loosely packed land lose their strength. And during earthquakes, the layers below the surface liquefy like water and structures collapse on it. Reclamation also brings damage not only to marine ecosystems, but also affects migratory birds. Christina Cinco of the Wild Bird Club of the Philippines says the Manila Bay is a stopover of migratory birds. Aside from this, some bird species endemic to the Philippines can only be found in areas near Manila Bay. Pamalakaya, a fisherman group, and other fisherfolk organizations have long opposed reclamation, saying this left a big damage to livelihood of thousands of small fisherfolk in the country. In an earlier interview with ABS-CBN News, the Philippine Reclamation Authority said various sectors have been consulted before the approval of these projects. As of now, there has been conflicting counts on the number of ongoing reclamation projects in Manila Bay. PRA said there are 13, while Oceana said there are as much as 20 ongoing reclamation projects. Ron.
Jervis Manahan with that story. Thanks, Jervis. The latest now on the oil spill crisis in Oriental Mindoro. The health department recommends a relocation of vulnerable individuals to safer areas. Acting Health Chief Maria Rosario Vergeri says those include the elderly and those with lung complications.
Those within 100 meters from the affected area cannot drink their water. They have to be supplied with water, safe water, by the local government. Doon sa mga nakatira within 100 meters, kailangan i-relocate ang mga matatanda at may mga sakit sa baga. Lalabas sila at dadalhin doon sa mga kamag-anak na medyo malayo-layo doon sa lugar.
Authorities have also barred residents from swimming in affected areas. That's after water samples there failed a standard quality check. Environment officials warn direct contact with contaminated waters could lead to skin diseases.
Ang ating makikita dyan, inhalation. So we're expecting mga respiratory signs and symptoms. Yung may mga pre-existing asthma, yun ang talagang titingnan natin. We're expecting yung mga dermatitis kasi direct exposure sa skin.
The Philippine Transportation Department says it will encourage the use of locally produced modern jeepneys for the proposed modernization program of public utility vehicles. Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista says they have already talked to several local companies to manufacture these modern jeepneys. However, some of these companies note sales have been low because their units are too costly. Bautista says they are ready to discuss possible solutions with the groups who joined the transport strike.
Yung mga nakausap namin ay naintindihan nila yung aming ipinaliwanag, no? Kaya nga sinasabi ko kay Mar Balbuena, magkita kami at papaliwanag ko sa kanya para maintindihan niya kung ano ba yung program na gusto nating